we have a story about Oklahoma heroes. You've probably heard about them, the Choctaw Code Talkers. And I'm actually joined by Choctaw Chief Gary Batten. Thanks for being here with us.
Halito, Steve. Thank you for having me.
Because you guys have a great push right now to try to get even more recognition for one of the Code Talkers, and we'll get to that in a moment. But first, I was hoping if you could refresh my memory and people at home. Tell us about the Code Talkers and why they were so important here in American history.
Well, the Code Talkers were used our Choctaw language to help end World War I. And what they did at that time was they were intercepting our signal and everything else, and they could translate the English and basically break down what was going to happen. So they used our language, which they could not break that language at all, that barrier, and is able to end World War I.
Just using the Choctaw language there, because the other sides didn't know how to decipher it.
Exactly.
Now, a lot of people, including people in the Choctaw tribe, didn't even know this had happened for decades, right? Because they were sworn to secrecy?
Exactly. Most of the time they were asked to keep it as a secret because they were going to use it, and they did in World War II. And so if they did, that was actually sending people over here to find our tribal members and other tribes to try to break that language and so that they could interpret it and know what was going on. And so it was a hidden secret for many years, and I was so proud of our tribal members that they were very humbled and they kept it quiet, kept it a U.S. secret.
Well, it's also part of Choctaw culture too, that your word is your honor.
Exactly. It is our bond, and it is about us being humble as well.
Now, I know when the story finally came out and you received a lot of recognition, say 5 or 10 years ago when there was the book and the movie as well, there were some recognitions, including the Silver Star awards from French military, but you guys are now making a push to get a Congressional Medal of Honor.
That's correct.
And that's essentially the highest award.
Yes, it is. And we're specifically looking to get that for Joseph Oklahoma.
For one person. Yeah, so tell us about Joseph's story, because his story is truly remarkable. And I know you have a photo here.
Yes,
I
do.
Hold it up. We'll get a picture of him too, so you guys can see what he looks like here at home. If you want to hold it right up to that camera right there. So tell us about Joseph Oklahoma.
Well, Joseph Oklahoma was a full-blood Choctaw from Wright City, Oklahoma. His story, the reason why he is revered in our area along for the state of Oklahoma, is because Joseph fought for 4 days, held the enemy line. He literally went past their line, got a hold of one of their guns, and actually captured 171 soldiers and brought them back. And he went without food and water for 4 days while he was doing this battle. And so to me, if you put that into days, people would say he's an American hero. But yet, well, that's the reason why we're trying to get the Congressional Medal of Honor for him, for his family. He had a son by the name of Jonah. And you know, he's passed away as well. So for us, it's about making sure we keep our history and our culture alive and what Joseph stood for. I mean, if you can imagine, I just want to make Joseph a little real to people.
Sure.
Back then, you know, it wasn't great to be a Native American. He actually walked 22 miles from his home to enlist in the military. And even after he came back from the war and after all the heroic deeds he did, they even asked him to do a movie. He said he didn't want to do the movie. He was very humbled. He went back and worked at a sawmill. And most of his family didn't even know all the heroic deeds
Wow.
that he did. And so for me to be able to see what he has done, we need to honor him. He is just like Audie Murphy, I mean, in my opinion. He is a great American hero.
So where are things at right now, you know, and what's the process like to try to get this accomplished?
Well, you know, we started this in the 80s, and used to it truly went through an act of Congress. Now it goes through the military, and that's where we're needing a lot of everybody's help, is because there's very few records. You know, if you can imagine 1918, there just was not a lot of those records available. If there is family members that know, Indian, non-Indian, that knows the story of Joseph Oklahoma, we need to have those so that we can share that, so that we can make the push with the military to get the Congressional Medal of Honor.
So people perhaps who have heard from their parents or their grandparents stories like this of what he did. I mean, when we're talking about the fact that he single-handedly captured 171 Germans, he held that machine gun nest for 4 days, he was standing up there without food, without water. You guys are trying to make this push, and you're trying to get the stories to be able to do that.
Exactly. And that's the reason why I appreciate you, Steve, just even airing this, because I think this is going to be important to share. This, he is an Oklahoman as well. And so I'm sure there's other Oklahomans that have heard this story. So anybody out there that hears or has any information, please let us know so that we can document it and we can get any letters of support for getting the Congressional Medal of Honor. We need that.
And Chief, real quick, just explain to people, if the Choctaw Code Talkers weren't part of World War I, where would things have ended for us? Would the war have ended like it did, or would it have ended as soon?
Of course, I'm biased. So yeah. I would say that no, it wouldn't have ended the way it did. I mean, they would have continued intercepting our signals. They would have known where we were going, what was going on. And I think we changed the war. I really do.